Adobe just introduced improved cloud-based processing for the select subject and remove background tools. That means the heavy lifting is done on Adobe servers, giving you sharper, smarter selections, especially on complex elements like hair, transparent fabric, or foliage. Let's jump in and see exactly how this new AI-powered upgrade works. In this example, I'm going to use select subject, and I'm going to use the cloud processing in the previous version of Photoshop, the one before Photoshop 26.6. So I'm in the previous version of Photoshop, and I want to make a selection of these palm trees here. I'm going to use select subject. I'm on the object selection tool, and at the top, I'm going to click on select subject, and you can see that cloud is selected for detailed results. So I'll click on select subject. I'll add a layer mask, and you can see that a lot was missed on that selection. Now we're going to use the same image to compare the brand new updated features featuring cloud processing using Photoshop 26.6. Before we get into our examples, let's make sure that you could take advantage of this new improved feature. We're going to start off with select subject, and you could see the select subject at the top if you activate any of the selection tools, or you can actually hit select subject from the contextual taskbar. But if we drop down select subject, you could see on my computer, cloud detailed results is checked. We've had cloud detailed results for a while, but this is where the improvement is in Photoshop 26.6. We had it in the previous version. Let's make sure that every time we use select subject or remove background, that it's going to use cloud detailed results. To do that, go to where your settings or your preferences are on Mac under Photoshop settings and go to image processing. With image processing selected here, you see select subject and remove background. Cloud detailed results is right here. It's highlighted, it's checked. So once you have that checked, say okay, and you may have to restart Photoshop for that to take effect. So now every time we use select subject or remove background, it's going to use the new improved cloud-based processing for a select subject and remove background. So we're going to click on select subject, and we have our selection. And if you want to see this different ways, you could either click on select and mask and choose any of the different views. There's on layers. I'm going to zoom in here. You can see the detail that it's selected on white, on black. So on black, that's where you're going to see how the layer mask looks pretty much. You can see that the palm leaves are very well defined, and it has made a great selection. There's going to be times where even for this improvement, the select subject is not going to be perfect. You may have to use the refine edge tool here in select and mask, and another help might be contaminate colors. But what we're going to do is we're going to output this as a new layer with a layer mask. I'm going to say okay. So again, I'll show you the layer mask. I'm going to hit option on my keyboard and click on the layer mask, and you can see the detail here in our layer mask. It's made a pretty good selection. And to show further how good this is, I'm going to turn on my color fill layer, and I can use my color picker to change color anything that I want, just to show how good this looks. And it looks pretty good, say on a white background or a darker blue background. So a big improvement. Let's try another example. In this example here, you might want to see the hairs on the side of the dog, both around his face and under his body here. You might want to see detail there. Again, I'm going to the object selection tool. I'm going to click on select subject, and I'm going to add a layer mask. And if I put a black background on it, you can already see that cutout isn't showing too much detail in the fur, especially down here at the bottom and on the sides. We would really have to get into select and mask to work with this, but we're showing as soon as we make a selection. In this example, we're going to start with remove background. When you hit remove background, you automatically have a layer mask already added for you. Here I'm going to show the layer mask, zoom in a little bit, and look how nicely those fine hairs on the side of the dog and on the bottom of his body, his nice fur. So cloud processing is so much better now. Edge refinement is way better. And I can add a solid color adjustment layer, can choose any color. That's pretty darn good. Way better than the previous version. Hair is always going to be an interesting problem, whether it be human hair or fur on an animal. So in this case, maybe you would want to go back and try and see if selected mask can make it better. But for the most part, this did a pretty good job, and that's pretty good for a black background. Now keep in mind, cloud processing does require an internet connection and might be slower depending on your speed, but it's absolutely worth it. And here's the layer mask one more time. Pretty good definition on that fur. So with the previous production version of Photoshop. I'm going to try select subject on this motorcycle. I expect to get details like the spokes and the wheels and all of the intricacies up here on the handlebars. So if I click on select subject, click on a layer mask, and you can see that it even missed the gas tank, or it selected the gas tank. It missed these areas right here where the spoke is. If I turn off the layer mask, you can see the details that are missing in this selection, or it selected too much. And here's the mask itself. You can see parts of the wheel where it didn't select, and up here at the top, pretty jagged selection. So you may have seen other demonstrations of this particular feature. Instead of using a bike, I'm going to use a motorcycle, and I'm going to use remove background. Turn that layer mask on and off. Zoom in here a little bit. So I don't see any areas where it missed just by turning on and off the layer mask. Here is the layer mask. All the spokes are intact on each wheel. Detail that you can see in the bike up here on the handlebars and on the frame. Again, I can add a solid color adjustment. Move this below subject. There it is on a black background. Big improvement over the previous version's cloud processing. Change any color I want. Still looks good. It's amazing with the spokes though. So let's try another example here. Now let's try and get a couple of things here. When we make a selection here, we expect to get a good cutout of the tennis racket, all the parts of the body, in the hair. Let's see what the previous version of Photoshop did. Again, select subject. Here's my layer mask. You can see the same color. It didn't even select inside the tennis racket. If you look closely, you can see on her arm right here where the selection was not too good. Of course, because you have the layer mask, you could fix it, but we're trying to make a good selection, trying to show what the new improvements on select subject are. Again, you can see around the arm that it didn't select very good. Also the hair, you could see that didn't do a good job there either. We put a solid color adjustment under there. It didn't do too bad a job. It could be refined with selected mask, but here is the mask, and you see it's jagged along the edges here, and it has to be refined in the hair, but the selection didn't do it. So a couple of things to focus on here. First, the tennis racket that is partially out of focus, the detail in her hair and also her body. We want to see how this new cloud-based selection works. I'm going to click on select subject in the contextual taskbar. I'll add a layer mask myself this time. One thing you can see is the edges are really good. The hair is, well, cutting out hair is always difficult, but here's where selected mask is going to help out. But still, you can see the layer mask has got some pretty good definition of some of those hair strands. Let's see how it did if we put a solid color adjustment behind it. That's pretty darn good. On a black background, the hair strands are defined very good. It's an excellent cutout. And look at the racket. You can see the inner part of the racket. It still cut the background out in between those fine areas in the racket. Of course, you can see how this looks with other colors. Racket still looks good. Here shows you want a white background. This is what's going to happen. I think the black background looked good, or blue. That color is going to work with very little, if any, fine tuning of the mask. So if you want better results without spending extra time on masking or cleanup, this feature is a game changer. Let me know in the comments if you tried it and what you think. If this helped you out, drop a like, hit subscribe, and tap the bell so you won't miss more tips like this. Remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching.